First thing we do is serve people some ice wine with some foie gras. That's the opening entree. And it's a great way to introduce the meal. And if you do a Riesling, which is very bracing acidity that you get in the Riesling, it's a great way to cleanse your palate too, to start the meal off.
When you think about what we're dealing with here, we've got terrific aromas. The flavor profile is massive. It's got a ton of sweetness, but then it's backed up by this backbone of acidity. So the typical offering has always been to serve it at the end of the meal as an aperitif or as a starter course. When you look at challenging the wine, either with a spice profile, like in this case, this is a tagine with North African flavors. So we have
this one here.
Yeah, dried fruits and nuts, and that'll stand up to the wine.
If you're looking for interesting wine combinations and pairings, I mean, like spicy food, when you add ice wine to spicy food, you sort of lessen the heat, and you'll be able to open up your threshold a little bit for spicy food. And
the other option for a starter is challenging it from a texture point of view. So if it's crunchy, super hot, and even sort of got a sweetness on it, it'll stand up to the end.
I just had a nice apple pastry, and I was having it with the ice wine, and it was really magnificent because you get that flakiness of this beautiful pastry. And it was great with this 97 ice wine, which has got a little bit of age and some additional flavor and texture to it.
My signature ice wine dessert is something I demonstrated actually at the Olympics at the Niagara Ice Wine Trifle. What I like to do is poach those fruits in an ice wine syrup, and I layer that with a simple sponge cake, and then I make almost a tiramisu style mascarpone cream using ice wine, and I layer that with the cake and the fruits, and that is just Niagara through and through.
Trying to match sushi with ice wine. The influence of Asian cuisine in our cuisine with our ice wine started to open up a whole myriad of combinations of food experiences, so that the foodies can get a little crazy when it comes to combining our ice wine with food that normally people in North America wouldn't do. That sixth scent that you get in your palate, so you got the five senses, and then you got the sixth one, which is a combination of elements within the food. It's always a great experience to taste this against one of the great wines of the world, because then you don't have to say anything. Just try it with other dessert wines, and then it'll speak for itself. It's very uniquely Canadian in its identity.